Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thanks for coming, everybody. The few that are not deer hunting, happens to be opening season for rifle or opening day. So it's almost like a holiday around here.
That's for sure.
Roll call.
Mark Bouchard.
Here.
Maureen Bory.
Here.
Joanne Shirkey.
Here.
Artie Bryson.
Here.
Christy Hilton.
Here.
Chris O'Regan.
I'm here.
Cindy Valentine here.
Okay, we're all here. First time in a long time we had a full board.
That's good.
Since August.
For one reason or another. Bills payable. I'll entertain a motion.
I'd like to make a motion to approve bills payable in the amount of $142,477.75.
Support.
Okay, a motion and support. Any discussion? Hearing none. Roll call.
Maureen Bory.
Yes.
Joanne Shirkey.
Yes.
Artie Bryson.
Yeah.
Christy Hilton.
Yes.
Chris O'Regan.
Yes.
Cindy Valentine. Yes. Mark Bouchard.
Yes.
All right, motion passes. I'll move right into my supervisor's report. Just wanted to tell the board the St. Clair County Road Commission completed the culvert project at the B Lane and Steyr. Put in a couple manholes, a couple cross culverts, and looks pretty good. Been dealing with a lot of building and blight issues. We have quite a few court actions going on along with dangerous building and blight. Did want to mention, I'm getting phone calls. The old Big River Grill, we do have it on our dangerous building list, and the owners indicated that they are willing to tear it down themselves. We're not going to have to take action. The holdup is there's a DTE pole right next to the building that we're waiting for DTE to remove the pole. And they're just not being very speedy at doing that. But before they can safely tear it down, that pole has to be relocated. If you see it, it's right by their old kitchen, right against the existing building. working on finalizing the audit, and we've been talking. It just seems like it's taken a long time this year. We got a good jump on it, and we're just waiting for them to finish the numbers up. They have everything they need, as far as I'm aware, to do that. So hopefully next week or two we'll have it finalized. And also doing a lot of work on our pension liability bonding, which is on our agenda tonight. We had an hour and a half long conference call today with Standard & Poor's bond rating people and interviewed us and went well. So doing a lot of work on that. Township office hot water heater needs replacement. Well, that was around lunchtime it did, but it got replaced this afternoon. So, and we do have someone checking out the cameras. One of our cameras, we have three in here, is not working, and is kind of not working great. The other ones, and there was some issues on the display in the video room. So I had an expert come out and check it out. He tweaked it up. I'm getting quotes on high def cameras to put in here, so it will make a clearer picture, a better picture, and so they can see it better, Joanne.
Good.
Been having a lot of conversations. We have in our budget for this current year budget $148,000 for additional emergency sirens. It's five of them, right, George?
Yep.
for the island and the mainland, basically to cover the whole township. And George had the people come out and do an audit where we should place them and everything. Then we actually started talking to Dave Vandenbosch, our county commissioner. Well, I'll get him here at one of our meetings. He's actually putting in for the county to buy two of the emergency sirens for us. And he's been also working with other townships, Cotterville and Casco, I know, to increase it with their I don't think they have any. And also they're going to hopefully, and this is all their county ARPA money, and this will also take care of a transfer switch for our generator between the police and the township, which we need a new transfer switch on that generator. So that's good. So we're waiting for that to come out, and there may be actually some overlap that will help Cotterville out in the north part of Clay as far as the coverage. So we're looking at that pretty aggressively now. We're looking for a member for the Elginac Clay Library Advisory Board, which we do have someone now. And been working on our bicentennial celebration. After Thanksgiving, I'm going to really amp that up. But and I've been working on with the county, IRA, and Elginac on a new water treatment or wastewater treatment plant agreement. Have a meeting coming up here in about a week with myself and the county to iron that out. And we're researching and looking for funding opportunities for our water main replacement project and the sewer interceptor project still. There's a lot of opportunities coming up forward, and hopefully we'll get large portions of both of those projects funded and taken care of. We have been notified, actually, Clay Township, just the past day, that our assessing department will be audited. They call it the AMAR audit. We are anticipating it would be the following year, but they're actually going to audit us this spring on this last year's tax rolls that are going on. So Sherry was kind of upset, not upset, but it's a lot of work for her. And wanted to mention last week they had a bump and run event in Elginac. They raised, what was it, about a total of about 5,000 people there, Mark?
That's correct, over the 2 days. Yeah.
Over 2 days, and they
5,000.
Yeah, they
in little old Smithfield.
I know
they had the bleachers.
They raised a lot of money, more money than they thought they were going to for charity. I heard numbers around, and this is, this is what I've been told, that there's around $15,000 that's going to go towards scholarships.
Yep, absolutely.
And I know they wanted to do scholarships for trade schools and tech schools with that $15,000. Oh, yeah. So it's a very good. So glad for the the organizers and everyone who put it on.
It was a lot of fun. If you didn't attend it, you missed something spectacular.
Jake Scarbeck, I know, headed that up. So big kudos. That's all I have. Any questions? All right, we have public comments. Do we have any public comments? No public comments? Okay. Just checking. Moving right along to the consent agenda, I will entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda consisting of communication, resignation of Nancy Stewart from our library board, meeting minutes from November 1st, and check reports.
Support.
Okay, we have motion and support. Any questions? Hearing none. All in favor of the consent agenda, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Anyone oppose? Motion carries. Next, we have our fire chief report. The only man is not duck or deer hunting.
No, I'd let them all go.
Yeah.
Good evening. Chief's report for October. During the month of October, I attended only one meeting, and that was the St. Clair Flats Homeowners Association on Harson's Island. I did not attend the County Chiefs Association meeting. They've changed the meeting date to during the day, so it's kind of hard getting away from doing the day-to-day business at the fire station, so I will try to make as many meetings as I can during the day. Pump testing was conducted on all the trucks during the month of October. They passed, and the safety checks were conducted too. Trucks are in good running order. We did fire prevention, or October was fire prevention month. Fire department conducted classes at the Elginac Child Care Center, Millside Elementary, and Algonquin Elementary. We had over 450 kids that we instructed for the 2 days, which was pretty good. I'd like to thank Sergeant Carr, Firefighters Hubert and Kern, and Lieutenant Hughes for giving the classes. They were the ones that conducted classes. Fireboat one was pulled out during October. We've had some issues with one of the motors, and it's being evaluated. So once I find out, I'll be coming to the board on what the issues is with that outboard. Fireboat two is back in the water. So if we have any rescue runs, or if we have to go out on any duck hunters, we do have a boat in the water that we can respond. The fire department attended the Scarecrow contest last month. We passed out candy, hats, and handouts to all the children. I also found out today that Jay Jeffries passed his EMT class. Good. So he is now a state certified EMT. Congratulations, Jay. And I also would like to thank Chris O'Regan for his help in repairing, getting our roof repaired at Station 1. We had a couple minor leaks there, and he guided us and got it corrected and fixed. So we're back in business. Thank you, Chris.
You're welcome, Chief.
I have one question on Firebolt 1. Has that received any of the new engines?
No, they still have the old motors on it. Okay. And that boat was purchased in 2005. I've been talking to Artie and Cindy and Chrissy about going for possibly a port security grant for a new boat this coming year to replace that boat. It's time to replace it. It's seen its day.
I never liked that boat from day one. Yeah. It's, in my mind, it's top heavy.
Yep.
It's not, I'd like to see him in a better boat. The new engines that we paid for, it's for the other boat that we have.
The rescue boat.
That's still in the water.
Okay.
How are we doing on the airboat, Chief?
The airboat's sitting in our fire station now. We've been doing some training on it, so.
Yeah. So we have that one available also.
Yep. Plus, I have the other one on the island.
Right.
So.
Okay. Any questions for Chief?
Is the airboat rigged and ready to go?
It has all the equipment on it, yep.
Good.
Yeah. Looks good.
We did not budget for a canvas for the front like we have on the old one. We'll do that next year. Yeah. We'll get by what we have this year, and then next year we'll budget for a front cover for the...
Good idea.
Yeah, that was the plan.
So, yep.
So.
Hopefully we can get that grant. It's almost 20 years old, that boat, too.
Yep.
So.
Good job, Chief.
Thank you.
And we have FEMA grants coming up, right?
Yes, that opened up on the 8th, and we're working on deciding what we want to do, AEDs, radios.
Right. Okay. All right, thanks, Chief.
Thank you.
All right, under unfinished business, we have our principles of government. This is actually drafted by the Michigan Township Association. And first time I read it, I loved it. And so every board, and every time we get a new board, I like to pass it, and, which I would love to do here tonight. Someone want to read this? Who feels like reading this?
I'll read it.
Okay.
Clay Township, the principles of governance. To maintain the highest standards and traditions of Michigan townships, we embrace these principles to guide our stewardship, deliberations, and constitute services as we commit to safeguard our community's health, safety, and general welfare. So as a board, we pledge to insist on the highest standards of ethical conduct by all who act on behalf of this township. We bring credit, honor, and dignity to our public offices through collegial board deliberations and diligent, appropriate responses to constituent concerns. Actively pursue education and knowledge and embrace best practices. Treat all persons with dignity, respect, impartiality, without prejudice or discrimination. Practice openness and transparency in our decisions and actions. Cooperate in all reasonable ways with other governmental entities and consider the impact of our decisions may have outside our township's borders. Communicate to the public township issues, challenges, and successes, and welcome the active involvement of stakeholders to further the township's well-being. Strive for compliance with all state and federal statutory requirements. Refuse to participate in any decisions or activities for personal gain at the expense of the best interest of this township. Further the understanding of the obligations and responsibilities of American citizenship, democratic government, and freedom. These principles we pledge to our township, our state, and our country.
Thank you. Any discussion? Or can I entertain a motion, or someone want to entertain a motion?
Is this for all the boards, the planning commission?
I will give it to them.
I was going to ask yeah. the same thing, especially the planning commission and the ZBA.
Yeah.
They can
right.
apparently have more to do with far as
specific pieces of property that may
absolutely.
Be close to them.
Absolutely.
Yeah. yeah. And, I know I about 4 years ago we did this at the planning commission and the ZBA. So.
Well, last time I tried to bring it forward, they shut it down.
Yeah, so I know. I know.
I think it's good.
I didn't have anything. I know. Right. Why wouldn't you pass it? So.
Right.
Someone want to entertain a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve the principles of governance for the board of trustees and supervisors.
I'll support it.
Okay, we have motion to support. Any more discussion? Hearing none, roll call vote, please.
Joanne Shirkey.
Yes.
Artie Bryson.
Yes.
Christy Hilton.
Yes.
Crystal Regan.
Yes, I support it.
Cindy Valentine. Yes. Mark Bouchard.
Yes.
Maureen Borey.
Yes.
All right, motion passes. We wanted to do this when we had a full board, just because. All right, under new business, we have for consideration resolution 2021-39B for our MERS bonding resolution. So you want to just tell the board what we're doing? Can you come up here?
So today we went on our ratings call with S&P, and we think it went well. The previous rating was a double A, so we're hoping to remain a double A. Since the last time I presented on the MERS pension bond, the market has moved slightly. Luckily, the rates that we used in that presentation were fairly conservative. We added around like 50 basis points. So right now, the Treasury, the benchmarks moved about 40 basis points, but we're still on target. Even with that 40 basis point move, I added a little bit more buffer to the interest rates, just given everything that's kind of going on with inflation and whatnot, and kind of how the markets are reacting to all the bills that are passing federally. And we're still around approximately 40% savings, and that's a gross savings of $2.8 million, net, with a net present value of $1.9. We're just going to continue to monitor it, and you know, we'll let you know if anything drastic happens in the market, but ultimately, you know, we won't proceed unless the savings are adequate.
And correct me if I'm wrong, this is basically for a 17-year bond payment, or a bond or it'll be 17 years to retire this bond. And basically, instead of going now as we are paying MERS, how we're paying them every year, this, instead of that, we'll be paying off our bond and giving this money today to MERS to fund our pension liability. And in essence, in layman's terms, we're going to be paying around 2% interest on, for this bond. It's going to be $4.8 million. And with the money with MERS, we make, you know, between 6 and 9% interest historically. And they're still estimating a $2.8 million savings, right?
Yeah, that's gross savings before net present value.
So. Right.
Yep.
By pulling the trigger. So
that's over the course of these 17 years?
Yes.
Correct.
Yes.
And how much is that a year?
Well, it varies. It'll be more, how it's set up, there'll be more of a savings at the back end of it. Am I right?
Yeah, yep, that's correct. It's about, I think it was approximately $107,000, like the average savings, average annual.
Right.
And when is this effective?
Well, whenever we, it will be probably in January, right?
Yeah, we expect a price, given the resolution passes, we expected a price in early January, closed the bond issue late January. So pretty much everything will be all said and done, we're hoping, at the end of January.
So between now and then, if the market and everything else takes a nosedive, we don't have to initiate it?
Nope.
It's just to go with the process.
Just wanted to make that clear. And I assume that Christy, the treasurer, is on board with everything.
I'm on board.
Any questions, or we can do a motion and do have discussion if someone would like to make a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve resolution 2021-39B for MERS bonding resolution authorizing pension bond.
We have a second.
Support.
Okay, Joanne. Okay, any discussion or questions?
So let's back up the bus here a little bit.
Okay.
We have an underfunded pension program.
Yes, right? That's correct. Yep.
And part of this is legacy debt that they haven't addressed
most of it, yeah,
prior to our board. Certainly in the last term, but I remember talking about this 3-4 years ago as well. Mm-hmm. Right, this is a problem that's been going on for a while. So I support getting this back on its feet where it needs to be. Don't we need further discussion on how exactly we're gonna bond this out, but how is the township going to absorb some of these? Because this, we pay X amount to our pension program now, right?
Right. We have a 17-year plan with MERS right now to make us whole.
To make us whole?
100% funded in 17 years.
Okay.
By getting this bond and giving all this money to MERS now versus yearly payments, basically MERS does great with our investing our money. You know, like I say, they normally give us a 6 to 9% rate of return. Never seen it below that consistently. And so basically we're going to pay around 2% for this bond and give it to MERS and they're going to invest it today and make 9%, 6% on the money. And the difference of us paying every year like we do to MERS and have been doing, and that number fluctuates like crazy. It's impossible to budget for. And it's very challenging to say the least. That we'll know exactly what our interest rate and our payments are going forward. I mean, it's solid. It's rock solid.
Well, and I think it's also important to remind everyone that we closed this defined benefit plan, which is why it took so long to get to this point where we could bond it out, because we wanted to make sure it was closed.
Yeah, legally for us to do this.
We've gone a different route with defined contribution now instead, so we can't end up in this position again.
Right? Yeah, and to me it makes sense. I mean, there's the state allows us to do this. They changed the law, what, 3 years ago, Steve?
Yep, yeah, about 2017.
And they have strict guidelines to allow us to do it, and it has to make sense. And so what they're doing, too, they have to give everything to the Department of Treasury, and they're reviewing all the numbers.
Yep.
And the Department of Treasury is going to say, yeah, this makes sense for Clay Township to do it, or no, it doesn't. So it's just not us, and it's not our guys. It's the Department of Treasury is looking at this, and Standard & Poor's is looking at this. I mean, this is going through the, there's a definite process to get it approved because, I mean, you know, pensions, it should be. And that's why it's complicated and it takes a while to get done.
Yeah, yep, and we're required by Michigan law to have a minimum of 15% savings. It's in our comprehensive financial plan. We ran a bunch of sensitivity analysis, say if MERS investment return dropped or if it increased. We did multiple runs pretty much of the numbers to kind of like stress test it to make sure that any sort of drastic change in the market would still, you know, it would still make sense.
And how we got in this position, be quite honestly, from decisions and things that happened back in the 90s, mm-hmm. that, you know, there was moves made and maybe someone gave someone an early out or this or that, and there wasn't, it wasn't reflected in the rates paid back in the 90s to get where we are today.
Basically, they let a couple of people retire, and they didn't put the funding in for that retirement.
Yeah,
let them retire early without funding it,
you know, and that's how it gets out of whack.
And that balloons.
Right. A lot. So.
So the longer we wait, the higher that number grows? Is that a fair assessment?
It could potentially, yeah. Like, right now, given with the interest rate, like, you know, it's going to start limiting your ability to with interest rates rising on taxable rates. With that being said, you know, with the, like, your return on your assets from the MERS plan, it's kind of hard to judge, you know, what it's going to be like in the future. But essentially, Right now, it just, with interest rates being so low, it definitely makes sense.
Yeah, if we wait 6 months, we could be paying 2.5% versus 2 or whatever, who knows? I don't have a lot.
So you can predict the market, but you can't, I mean, you can't predict the market, but you can define it.
Yeah. Yeah, essentially, and that's why we run so many stress tests. Like, if you look through the comprehensive financial plan, it will show if, I think it goes up and down 200 basis points for whether your return will, or whether you'll be getting a higher return, a lower return, what interest rates would look like on our end. Typically, we're allowed to add, I believe it's a 50%, or it's a 50 basis point buffer. And I usually add that in just to make sure that we're at really conservative rates because, you know, just in the short term, since we last had this discussion, Treasury rates have moved about 30 to 40 basis points through all the Treasury benchmarks.
So you asked a stupid question. Who's the underwriters on the...
We will be Northland Securities.
Pardon?
Northland Securities.
Okay. So, given all that, they're projecting a 40% savings, which basically is $2.8 million over the 17 years. Tell me where else we can make money like that. I don't know.
Saving, we're not actually making
right.
Money.
We're saving.
We're saving the money.
Saving taxpayers.
We've
got
to shell out 4.8 to get there, right?
It's cost avoidance,
right?
This may be the largest thing we've voted on, and certainly in recent history.
Yep,
this is a big one.
It's our big elephant in the room, and quite honestly, there's a lot of municipalities that are a lot worse than us, and you know, so it's really easy to kick the can down the street where a lot of people places are, and which Clay Township did 20 years ago too. And you know, it's the largest liability the township has, and it's going to be funded. The employees are going to like it because, say, if Clay Township went bankrupt and it's not funded, they could potentially lose your pension. Mm-hmm. Clay Township employees are going to look, hey, our pension plan's funded right now. Not a lot of people can say that. Not a lot of entities can say that. And to shift gears a little bit, there's a OPEB. It's for basically medical retirement, medical liabilities. We were behind in that, and due to the market and us contributing money, we are actually, Paul Bailey called me up and goes, without doing the big thing with the numbers study, which because we're looking at 77-78% funded, which is great, but he goes, once next year when we were required to do a detailed audit on our OPEB liability, he goes, we're probably going to be, if not real close to 100% funded on our post-retirement medical. There's not too many entities around that I know of that will be able to say that are both our pension plan and our OPEB are 100% funded. And, you know, that's legacy costs. And, our people that come after us, I think, are going to thank us for this.
I will tell you, when I got into office in 15, and that was one of the things that Artie and I first sat down about, was this MERS, and we couldn't even say the word without your eyes getting all glassy, because MERS is very hard to understand. But this was one thing we said that we weren't going to kick down the road like everyone else did. So I'm glad that I'm still here to be able to address it at this time with you, Artie.
Yep. So we have a monthly or yearly obligation currently to MERS, right? Which is what we've been doing, right? That's our status quo. So now, in addition to the status quo, we've got to come up with a monthly payment to satisfy this 4.8 over the next 17 years.
Yes.
But the monthly will be greatly reduced.
Yeah, it's the way that we have it figured is we have, which is your unfunded actuarial liability.
Mm-hmm.
And when you bond for it, you pretty much you cut that payment down, and our savings are based off of like the remaining payment that you would make, because we're only allowed to bond under Michigan law for 95% of it. So the remaining payment still goes into effect, or it plays a factor in the savings. It's all calculated for based on pretty much how much we're taking out, how much we would need to fund it annually.
So is it front loaded? Is it like a mortgage where it's heavy interest on the front and it's heavier principal towards the year 17,
With the bond sizing that we ran it level debt service, so it would be roughly the same payment. With your MERS UAL payment that MERS provided us, it looks like theirs grows a little bit. It goes from $519,000 to $720,000. But ours would be pretty much level at approximately like $350,000.
And the difference already we'll work on through the budgeting process?
Yeah. I mean, and that's one of the things I got to get with them. We got to figure out when we do this is how much of the bond payment do we portion to police, to fire, or not fire, but water and our office, just so we can do it. It'll probably help police out the greatest on a yearly savings, which, you know, they can definitely use it.
Yep, and yeah, we'll be able to give you guys the detailed reports,
right?
Once everything's all said and priced, you know, we'll be able to show you how much each of the divisions will be receiving into their plan as well. So, yeah, we can give you kind of like a breakdown of anything you need. A lot of it, though, is in the comprehensive financial plan. Those numbers are, you know, given they are from September, but they're still, we would say, fairly close to the market currently as well because of the added buffer to the rate.
So as a board, if we approve this today, what's your next step?
Well, we'll have to go to Treasury, and we have to meet with Treasury and go over pretty much our entire comprehensive financial plan that the township has submitted, or that they approved. So we'll just have to go through everything, make sure nothing was missed, and that the state is in agreement that we meet the savings percent, which on a pension bond, it's 15%, and they're pretty much going to go through the entire plan to make sure everything's accurate.
Then you bring it back to us again?
Yes.
Okay. So we're kind of giving you the authorization to get the ball rolling. And
yes, that's correct.
Keep going.
And well, we talked about this before.
Oh, yeah. So.
Yeah, have we seen the financial plan other than the budget?
A little bit last time.
A little bit. I mean, it's what we call it, the POS, right?
On the township's website, I believe it's the entire comprehensive financial plan's listed. It pretty much details all of the reports that MERS gave us, all of our assumptions, given a bunch of sensitivity analysis, and which divisions are being funded, which are the exact amount that they're underfunded by.
When was the last time that was updated?
So this is resolution 39B. 39A was the resolution we passed, which was the notice of intent when that was all posted and put in your board packet. Okay. So you've seen all of that. You just need to go back a few meetings.
I think it's like 133 pages long.
Yeah, I read every one of them.
I'm sure you did.
It was a big one.
It's updated, what, a month or two ago.
Okay.
Yeah.
So.
I remember.
Okay, any other questions or? Everybody good?
I think so, yeah.
We do have motion and support, right? Yeah. No more questions? Roll call, please.
Artie Bryson.
Yes.
Christy Hilton.
Yes.
Crystal Regan.
Yes.
Cindy Valentine, yes. Mark Bouchard.
Yes.
Maureen Bory.
Yes.
Joanne Shirkey.
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you for coming out.
All right. Thank you for having me.
Yeah. And I wanted to tell our board, Bill Roche is partner, or senior partner, right? Is
he? Yes. Yep.
He would have been here too, but he's being quarantined. His wife has... But she's okay, but he's in quarantine, so.
Good luck to him.
Yeah. I told him I'll send him a bottle of bourbon. I'll leave it at his doorstep and ring the doorbell. So, all right, thank you.
All right, thank you.
All right, next we have one of our policies is we receive any funds like donations or anything, we as a board have to approve it, just because we don't want somebody to, or an entity that maybe has ulterior plans, you know, try to buy us or something with a donation or something. I mean, that's just behind the policy, but we're talking, we got these ARPA funds that are being delivered to us. We need to follow our policy to approve it and accept it as a board. So that's next. And our total ARPA is $931,759, which we did receive half of that. What's that number, Chrissy?
465,879.50.
So to follow our policy, as we like to do, we should make a motion that the board, that we accept this ARPA money.
I'll make a motion to accept ARPA funds.
Okay. In the amount of?
In the amount of $931,759.
Support.
Is that the amount we received?
That is the
total.
The approval amount.
Right, but we only received the 465,879.50, right?
Right.
We received the first tranche, $465,879.50.
Support.
Okay, so we have motion and support to accept the ARPA funds. Any discussion?
I just want to note on the approval letter from the Department of Treasury, there's a note under the section called Next Steps, and it says reporting guidelines that there was a report due by October 31st. And State Treasury, State Treasury, I guess, I don't know if it came up from federal or not, but anyway, the revised due date for the reporting guidance is April 30th of 22.
Okay.
So did we get the first half on 9/22/21? Is that what this?
Yep.
And then we'll get the second half now within
next year.
30 days?
Next year.
Oh, okay. And we have to spend this? Is there requirements?
Yeah, we have guidelines. We're going to have a sit down and have a workshop on it. And
it has to be committed by 2024, and it has to be expended by 2026.
Six. So, in fact, part of it, I'm waiting on quotes for expanding our Wi-Fi, or not broadband, throughout the rest of the county. A few other things too. So as a board, that's one thing I think we should do here later this winter or spring. We'll we'll see what money we have and prioritize it towards which projects we want it to go towards.
Because it's very, very, very specific what this money can be spent on.
Right. Okay.
So. So I'll entertain a motion. Oh, we have a motion, right, to accept.
Motion.
We have support?
Yep.
Okay, any questions, or do we want to send it back?
No, sir.
Nope. Hearing none, all in favor of accepting the ARPA funds as motion, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
We should probably do a roll call on that.
Yeah, we probably should. I was thinking about it for a policy, but go ahead, let's do a roll call.
Christie Hilton?
Yes.
Chris O'Regan?
Yes.
Cindy Valentine, yes. Mark Bouchard?
Yes.
Maureen Bory?
Yes.
Joanne Shirkey?
Yes.
Artie Bryson?
Yes, motion carries. Next, we have an asset disposal of a 2002 GMC pickup truck in the water department. And truthfully, I mean, I don't even think this truck is safe to drive. I'm not exaggerating either. I mean,
it's in poor shape. Huh?
So it's a bump and run?
Yeah. It would be a very good candidate. Just like my minivan blew a head gasket. I'm trying to save it for.
I believe the Enterprise politely declined right. to take this vehicle and try and auction it.
Right. We tried to get it to an auction. They said no. And we have an offer for $200, cash offer, and that's what.
And it is a township employee.
Yeah, to a township employee, and he knows that the condition of it. And
can't ensure there's no liability involved.
Right, and it's being sold as is.
Can't we scrap it for $400 or $500?
Not anymore.
No?
Depends on the catalytic
price. Probably have to pay Bob.
Steel went down again?
Yeah.
All right.
Probably have to pay Bobby Johnson $100 to take it away.
Right. Yeah, so yeah, that's what,
Any brass left in it?
No brass.
Board, I'll make a motion to support the DPW asset disposal of the 2002 GMC pickup.
Support.
For $200?
For $200.
$200.
Support?
Support for $200.
Okay, motion and support. Any more discussion? Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Motion carries. Okay, next we have a vacancy on our library board, and we have Clay Township resident Colleen Rowland that submitted interest in serving on that board. And so I'm nominating Colleen to serve on our library, Elginac Clay Library Advisory Committee or board.
Where does she live at?
Lee Street, I believe.
Okay. I'll make a motion to appoint to the library board Colleen Rowland.
Support.
Okay, a motion of support. Any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Anyone oppose? Motion carries. All right, move us right down to board member comments. Cindy.
I just want to say congratulations to Jay Jeffries on his EMT certification and welcome to Colleen Rowland.
Okay, thank you. Chris?
Yeah, PSA time. It's fall, and you get one of these from me every fall. As far as taking care of your home, there's a couple things that you need to be doing right now. One, you need to be disconnecting all your outdoor plumbing and your hose reels and stuff. Take them inside. Two, if you have any crawl space vents, time to close them up. Three, gutters and downs need to be cleaned out for the winter. It's a really good time to do that. Most of the leaves are down now. And four, if you have any problem areas, if you have any ice damming, now is a really good time to install some heat tape. You plug that into an exterior outlet or a light switch, and that way when the snow comes, you simply flip a switch and you're golden. So it's a good time to take care of your home so it doesn't let you down this winter.
And
don't veer for deer.
All right, thank you. Chrissy?
I have quite a bit tonight. We're working on committing the winter taxes this week, and bills will go out at the end of the month. Thus, winter tax bill is payable beginning December 1st, and it's due February 14th. The township office collections for Goodfellow donations are in full swing. The FOP Bowl-a-thon, sponsored by the Algonac Lions, is Sunday, December 5th, 2021, at noon at Colony Bowl.
That's for Goodfellows, right?
Yes. There's a food giveaway that is Woodside and Downriver Goodfellows partnership. It is Monday, December 20th at 10:30 a.m. at the Algonac Fire Department. They will have boxes of food that include a turkey until they're gone. And then in the Treasury Department, we are working on the pre-shutoff letters that will go out at the end of this week for delinquent water accounts. And payment arrangements can be made by calling the township offices.
Thank you. Art?
The Planning Commission for November the 10th was canceled, obviously, and the next Planning Commission is December 8th. Agenda to be determined.
Okay.
That's all I have. Thank you.
Maureen?
Have a safe and happy Thanksgiving. Fill your freezers with deer and safe and happy hunting.
Okay. Joanne?
We have a ZBA meeting on Wednesday. We have two appellates. They're all here on the mainland, and they don't seem to be serious complications.
Good. Okay. Congratulations to Jay for passing the EMT test. I know that's a challenging test, that's for sure. And also Colleen for coming up, stepping up and serving on the library board. I did want to mention a way cool event this past week on Veterans Day at the DNR on the island. They did a Veterans Day hunt. You had to have a veteran in your party. And they had 75, 80 parties, and you know there's usually 2 to 4 people in each party, so it was well intended. And Water Falls USA, they put together a real nice ditty bag, I'll call it, with a duck call and probably like $50 worth of stuff that each hunter got. And there was hot dogs and everything else. The veterans that were there, it was very well attended, and they was very well appreciated. It was a way cool event. It's one of those things where it makes you feel all warm and fuzzy inside.
So I just had a good day for it.
Yeah, it was a good day for
it. Shot some birds up.
I shot one duck that day. That was it.
That's it.
At least you got one.
Yeah, they're starting to do good. This wind is bringing them down. So,
yeah.
And I just want to wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving, and be safe, and hope everyone can spend it with friends and family, and don't forget to hug each other, even if they might have, you know, if they're vaccinated or not. I don't care. So anyone wants to hug me, have at it.
I have one other thing to say. On the association meeting on Saturday, Artie came to the island. It was packed with people, and he did an excellent job explaining what was going on. Basically in the township, because the island people don't pay a whole lot of attention to what's going on. You know, he did a good job.
Thank you. Other than that, one more motion?
Motion to adjourn.
Support.
Okay, thanks for coming, everybody. Everyone have a good Thanksgiving.